A week later, the disciples were together again. This time, Thomas was with them. Jesus came in while the doors were still locked and stood in the middle of the group. He greeted his disciples and said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and look at my hands. Put your hand into my side. Stop doubting and have faith." Thomas replied, "You are my Lord and my God." Jesus said, "Thomas, do you have faith because you have seen me? The people who have faith in me without seeing me are the ones who are really blessed." Those words come from John chapter 20, verses 26 to 29. Jesus said there is a great blessing for those who have faith that is not based on anything that they have seen. Was Thomas the only one there whose faith was based on seeing Jesus alive? Thomas had simply said that he wanted to be absolutely certain that it was Jesus and not an imposter. The rest of the disciples had faith that was based on seeing Jesus. It is a common condition of even believers today. Our faith is strengthened because we see irrefutable evidence that Jesus is real and is really moving in power in the world around us. Or we, like Thomas, say, "Lord, I will follow you if you will reveal yourself to me in this special way." Then, after figuratively touching the scars of Jesus, we declare that we are ready to be obedient to His word. I've always thought this special blessing is for all of us who cannot see Jesus in the flesh. I now think it is more. I believe there is a blessing for following Jesus without looking for confirmation in the physical world around us. When you hear the word of the Lord, you don't look for evidence in the world around you that confirms the word of God. Of course, the evidence is there, but you will be blessed if you spend your time walking the path He has set before you and not analyzing the circumstances. Lord Jesus, I choose to believe without seeing the evidence of your power and majesty. May my faith be based on love for you and not on the things I see. And may your name be praised forever. Amen.